Alrighty, welcome to the YS channel. So we're gonna do something a little bit different today. We're gonna do, I guess, final thoughts and tidbits regarding Neil Breen's pass through. However, we're just gonna take a big ass deep dive into the Breeniverse as a whole here and go over everything Neil Breen, you know, his humble beginnings and where he stands today as a world renowned filmmaker.
Well, for those of you who don't know, Neil Breen is from Las Vegas, and he makes most of his movies in Las Vegas. There's a great deal about what he did to earn the money he makes to make his films, but what we were able to track down was he was at one point a real estate agent, and supposedly if I read online, it's true. He got rich from investing his money in a food product line, and then enabled him to buy his famous Ferrari and to produce at least the first two of his films.
Yeah, because I know like all of his movies are for the most part self financed. So what we have up here on the screen, again, we're not able to authenticate this. But it looks like somebody on the internet did some snooping around, and they found his old-ass real estate agent card.
Uh-huh.
It looks like he used to work for Century 21. And this is back in the days where there was AOL.com.
Yeah. I'm reading the screen right now. It could be identical, because I know Century 21 at one point used to be 20th Century. Real estate or something.
I mean, it could be. Can you imagine this bugger being your real estate agent?
He must be really popular amongst people, because you have to be a people person just to do that job.
I'm just saying, like you've seen most of his movies. You know, the way, the dialogue and conversations are written. Could you imagine, introducing himself to, a prospective customer? The way he, introduced himself, in the movie? Hi, I'm Neil Breen. And the humans are stupid and outlive their usefulness. I'm going to cleanse the world of 300 million people.
I'm going to eliminate hundreds of millions of the human species. I am going to kill them immediately. But you have nothing to fear. I believe you're truthful and honest.
But bro, just sell our fucking house, man.
I am an AI god from outer space.
That's why he
tries to sell himself as.
He's like, your ideals are antiquated. How about I just take your house?
If it can be destroyed by the truth, it deserves to be destroyed by the truth.
I mean, there's so many things you can, run off with that, just regarding Neil Breen as a real estate agent.
Well, imagine him being a real estate agent, he shows up wearing that famous denim outfit.
The Bronze Star. The medal for gallantry in action. And I've never been so proud of our troops.
Yeah, exactly as it appears. He wins my war and terrorism medal. Bro, that's the basic training medal.
I'm surprised that didn't need to cancel him, but here we are in 2023, and his latest film, Cage, The Torture Crossing, which is a sequel to just a pair of movie we will review one day. Day is out in theaters right now, or I should say, it's like film festivals.
Yeah, dude, I can't wait for that. That'll be readily available for our viewing.
God. Well, when we do official findings as our next video, movie to review, we will show no mercy.
For those of you who are still hanging around for this whole Neil Breen deep dive omnibus, whatever you want to call it here, we actually decided to take the time here and go to his official website, the neilbreenfilmsllc.com. All things Neil Breen. And then, as you can see from the screenshot here, this is how this man chooses to market himself. The screenshot is obviously from his last film, Twisted Pair. And see him there all front and center. Shake his ass, fake beard, ever seen. And this guy thinks he's a prodigy to the indie film community.
We were reading up his tweets, and they came across that one tweet from before he shot his latest film, K the Tortured Crossing, where he's like asking money from other independent producers to fund his project, and this asshole was successful the first 5 times. Why not do it again? Which basically to believe Neil does not have enough money to keep on continuing making films out of his own pocket.
I mean, he's definitely made a profit doing this. How much of a profit? I don't know. We'll probably never know.
You gotta factor in this as well. Whatever profit he might have made, you gotta factor in his cost of living, his business expenses, and also the fact that he's funding his own movies. That profit goes away pretty quickly.
Well, again, I don't know what else this guy does in his spare time. So,
probably does nude somebody, where you try open your butt all to the sun.
He's sitting like, "Alright,
does this?"
Probably imagine this man just sitting there on a fucking mountain cliff, stretching his asshole to the sun.
Yeah, but that's a thing people do these days.
Fucking stupid. Like that latest TikTok trend to call like NBC emoji reacting or whatever. Like, look that shit up in your spare time. That is the dumbest fucking thing I've ever seen. But anyway, we're going a little too far off topic here.
I'd be basically saying TikTok my money.
But anyway, so I was at the Neil Breen website. So let's just jump in here where it says other oddities.
Oh, I want to see that. Let's see what it says.
Neil Breen Films, LLC, demand. Scroll down.
All right.
Neil Breen's films ranked. Gives a shit. Well, he considers Tommy Wiseau as competition.
That's actually horrifying. When Tommy Wiseau is a competition.
James David Lang.
What? Are you sure this is his actual website?
Yeah, this is off the Neil Breen website.
So, I don't know what it means by other oddities. Oh. Yeah, because that's fucking horrifying. He's comparing himself to Neil, to myself and the guy behind Birdemic.
that we got to click on where it says Breeniverse. Let's start with Neil's house. Because this is how you sell yourself to prospective film investors. Like, my house is an important star in my movies. Granted, you got a pretty nice house, but...
Oh, if you're rich enough, that would be to do that.
All right. So, Neil Breen's house appears on Parody. I'm pretty sure it appears in all of his movies.
Yeah.
All right, it says Double Down. It says the marriage proposal that turns into murder. And then... his daughter has brain cancer scene.
Oh, that's fantastic.
And then I Am Here Now. Pool scene with greedy politician and twins. That doesn't sound like something pornographic. Okay.
I'm pretty sure that is pornographic.
Okay. Faithful Findings. And then, of course, serves as his house once again. And the hospital room.
Dun, dun, dun. Under the stuff right here, he's doing what? I do when I make my own film. There was this asshole has the money to make feature-length films. And he's choosing to cut costs by filming at his crappy mansion.
Hey, look, at least he has a mansion.
Oh, mansion.
Money. like, you're a loser filming your movies out of the fucking, like, Fuller Ranch style house. He's got a fucking Vegas ranch style mansion. That's how he gets all these, like, bunny house wars to show up in the fucking movie. So obviously, I think he, besides the desert and a couple other, like, on location sites, obviously the house is like where he filmed a good chunk of those movies. It's obvious.
And well, so I'm gonna say this: it is yet has a mansion readily available for film production.
He does. So, but anyway, enough about his house. You know, talk about his cars. Because now his cars are important to the filmmaking process. His Ferrari, which, granted, wait, his Ferrari has its own website.
Why?
Oh my god. Anyway, Ferrari doubled down. So he's got an early 2000s Ferrari, which is, again, pretty fucking impressive. And then he spelled Ferrari wrong in the license plate. I don't know if that's intentional or not, but, you know, if you have a Ferrari, look, if you own a Ferrari and you're an independent filmmaker, you might as well find an excuse to have the Ferrari show up in your movies. With that said, I think we already kind of went over some of the, like, famous Neil Breen film clips. You know, there's not a whole lot else we can dive into. And what's the next movie we're going to do?
Well, our next movie, since we are now ripping apart Neil Breen, should be his magnum opus, which is Faithful Findings.
All right, well, then we're going to do Faithful Findings. All right, well, until next time, fools.
Committed suicide. I cannot believe you committed suicide. How could you have done this? How could you have committed suicide? I can't help you out of this one, Jim.